Hey kids, today we're making pumpkin streusel pound cake.
It's cooking and crafting, yeah, cooking and crafting. It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
Yep, it's the middle of the night and I feel like baking. So what I'm going to do is, in this small mixing bowl, I am going to put in 1.5 cups of flour, a teaspoon of pumpkin pie spice, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm going to set that on the side while we get the wet ingredients together. In this bowl I have a stick of butter, which is 1/2 cup of butter. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just beat this until it's nice and fluffy. Fluffy. I have 3 eggs and I'm going to add them one at a time until each is well incorporated. Make sure you scrape down the side. We're going to add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I'm adding in vanilla paste so it does look thicker. I always get asked, so I have to make sure I say so. Now I'm going to turn down the mixer to low and I'm going to gradually add in my flour mixture, and I'm going to alternate with 1/2 cup of canned pumpkin and 1/2 cup of sour cream. But first, I have to add in my sugar, I'm sorry. It's been a long day. So I'm just gonna put in a little bit of the flour mixture and I'm gonna mix that in. And then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna add in a little bit of the sour cream and I'm gonna mix that in. And then I'll add in a little of the pumpkin puree. And I'll keep going until all of it has been combined. And now a little bit of the pumpkin, and then I'm just going to continue to alternate. I'll bring you back when all of that's been added in. I already generously greased my bread pan, and I preheated my oven to 325. Almost. I'm just going to put this into my pan here. And in my bowl, I already have all the ingredients put together. It is 1/4 cup of firmly packed brown sugar. That's when you put the brown sugar into the cup and you pack it down nice and firmly. And then we also have 2 tablespoons of flour, 2 tablespoons of softened butter, 1/4 cup of finely chopped pecans or pecans, however you say your way, and 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. And I'm going to just go ahead and mix that up. All right, so I'm just going to, man, those planes have been going crazy all day today. Obviously, the butter isn't as softened as I would like it to be, so I think I'll have it sit out for just a little bit more under this light, and then we're just going to sprinkle that on top of the bread and put that into the oven. Hold on. Right, I put that in the microwave for about 4, 5, 6 seconds, something like that, and it got it right where I need it to be. I'm just going to keep mixing this until I get my nice crumbly streusel going. And we're back. And on it will go. Isn't as crumbly as I put in what little butter I had left. And it was a little over 2 tablespoons. Oops. Take it, you don't want to be a part of my bread. If you don't want to be a part of my bread, into the trash you go. All right, into the oven, 325 for 60 to 65 minutes. It already smells delicious. One can only assume that it's going to taste even better than that. Yum. This is absolutely delicious. Even my kitty thinks so. He's sniffing it. This is the strudel. The strudel sunk in. Now, I don't know if it's because I had just a little bit too much butter. I probably had about a half of a tablespoon to one tablespoon too much butter in the strudel. Anyway, it is delicious. Mom said, I wish there was more strudel, but she had the end piece where probably there wasn't as much. I hope you try this. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we have to say goodbye, make sure you